In this video, we'll install and configure a Pomerium Enterprise demo environment. This demo uses the same steps as our documentation. Before we begin, here's our starting state. I've created a wildcard DNS entry to point domains under demo.pomerium.io to this VM. I'm using a virtual machine running Debian 11 on Google Cloud with port 443 open. Redis and Postgres have already been installed and configured. I've also already configured Okta as an identity provider and saved the OIDC client credentials. I've installed Grafana as a demo service and added a user with my email address. Grafana has also been configured to accept the Java web token from Pomerium to authenticate users. We begin by installing Pomerium Core. From our documentation, go to Cloudsmith and select Set Me Up for Debian. Copy the provided script and paste it into the terminal to add the package repository. Now we can install Pomerium. Open the Pomerium configuration file. We'll update the placeholder domain values with our demo environment's domain. Next, we'll import our identity provider credentials. In this example, the service account value is base64 encoded JSON containing the API key. We'll also create two random keys, one for the shared secret and one for the cookie secret. Then we'll generate an OpenSSL key to use as a signing key. For this demo environment, we'll use AutoCert to generate SSL certificates for our routes, and we'll set Pomerium to listen on port 443. Since we're setting up for Pomerium Enterprise, we'll set Redis as our data broker storage and configure Pomerium to use the local Redis instance. We'll also configure a metrics listener for Pomerium Enterprise to scrape. Now we can save and exit this file. Before we can continue, we need to make a small adjustment to the service file so that Linux will let us use port 443 without root. Now we can reload the edited systemd file and start the Pomerium service. In our browser, we can confirm that Pomerium is working by navigating to the authenticate endpoint. Now to install Pomerium Enterprise. Copy this command from our documentation and insert your access key. This adds the Pomerium Enterprise console repository. Now you can install Pomerium console. Open the console configuration file. We'll first update the database URL to point to our local Postgres instance. Next, I'll add myself as an administrator. Then set the authenticate service URL to point to our authenticate service. In fact, let's change all example domains to match our demo environment. We'll copy the shared secret value used by Pomerium Core. Uncomment the Prometheus data directory key and create one more random key for database encryption. Now we can save and close this file and start the Pomerium console service. Now we'll go back to the Pomerium core configuration file and define the route for our Pomerium console. In the browser, we can navigate to console.demo.pomerium.io. Now let's create an example policy. Now we can create a route taking advantage of this policy. For this example, we're going to pass identity headers. Now when we go to grafana.demo.pomerium.io, we should automatically be signed in to Grafana using the Java web token provided by Pomerium. Our demo environment is now complete.